National Federation of the Blind. Live the life you want through science, technology, engineering, and math.
Hello, my name is Mark Barlow. I'm the industrial arts instructor at BLIND Incorporated in Minneapolis, Minnesota.
Mark explains how to use the click rule for measurements greater than 12 inches.
So we also have measurements in our world that are greater than 12 inches. This block of wood is smaller than 12. That PVC pipe is smaller than 12. But let's say I need to measure these two blocks of wood together. And so I've got two blocks of wood, and I need to make a block of wood the same distance as these two blocks of wood bumped up together. And so what I want to do is I'm going to set my click rule down, and I'm going to go, I can't use the fence because that's only 6 inches, and if I use the hook, well, that's 12 inches, and what I'm measuring is longer than 12 inches. So what am I going to do? What I'm going to do is use a really cool part of the click rule kit, and that is called an extension. And now what this does is gives me a built-in 12 inches, just like from the front of the fence to the front of the hook is a built-in 6 inches. Now I have a built-in 12. So I'm going to set this up. I'm going to set my fence against the side of the wood, nice and flush. The fence has to be flush against the side, and I'm going to slide that click rule in. I'm going to slide the information rod in until the extension, the end of the extension, is flush with the end of the wood. And here again, we're just a little bit in between a click, but I'm just going to call it even at this point. And I tighten my knob, and I take a look at that, and I begin counting. So I'm going to start my count on the information rod at 12, because I already have a 12-inch standard. This is where it begins. So we go 12 and a half, 13, 13 and a half, 14, 14 and a half, 15, and some mystery clicks. So 15, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 sixteenths, 15 and 4 sixteenths. 4 sixteenths can be reduced to 1 quarter. So it's 15 and a quarter of an inch.
Next, Mark puts the piece of PVC and long block of wood together end to end to create a piece longer than 1.5 feet.
I do not have the availability to make that measurement from the hook or from the fence. I'm all maxed out. I only have 18 inches here. So I need to use the hook of the click rule. So I set the hook against the end of the PVC to the left, and I take the end of the extension flush to the right, right here. One more click. There's my set, and I tighten the knob. And now I begin with what I know. I know I have 12 inches on the extension. I have 6 inches on the tube of the click rule, which is 18. And then I begin 18 and a half, 19, 19 and a half, 20, 20 and a half, 21, 21 and a half, 22, 22 and a half, 23, and some mystery clicks. How many? Just one. 23 and 1 16th. So that is the measurement that's the measurement of the PVC pipe, and the long chunk of pine from end to end is 23 and a 16th of an inch using the front of the hook. So when you're making an outside measurement, you have to let what you're measuring tell you what you need to use to make that measurement. You can't determine that you're going to use you're going to use the hook and one extension. You have to use what you need to make the measurement. So that is outside measurement. Well, before that, so I measured an object that was 23 and a 16th of an inch in length, and we have multiple extensions that are available. In my shop, I have a box of extensions. I don't even know how many. Many, many extensions. And so we can stack these extensions up. It is not uncommon that a student in my shop will need to make a measurement that requires 6 or 7 12-inch extensions plus the click rule to make a long measurement. And you can use as many extensions as you need to. I generally find that about 5 seems to be able to be carried by one person pretty well. If you're more than 5 or 6 extensions, it's good to have 2 people caring for that tool, because it does get to be long and kind of unwieldy, and they can get stressed out and broken. So we can make measurements in as long of a distance as the number of extensions that you have. If you had to, you could also place a tactile indicator of some sort at one spot in a measurement and continue measuring further down that object, either using a chunk of masking tape or dymo tape or anything that's tactily sizable for you to find a really clean edge to make a mark. So that's basic measurement with the click rule.
And that's how blind people do STEM. For more information, visit blindscience.org.